Good evening, my dear students. So today in this sessions we are going to learn third problem. A uniformly distributed load is acting on the cantilever B. How it is acting? So we will go through the question, then you can easily understand. Okay, third problem, a bar subjected to uniformly distributed load. So UDL load is acting on the cantilever beam. Okay, here on this cantilever beam, the taking Young's modulus value, it is given as 70 gigapascal, and the area of cross sections of this bar is given as 10 power of 4 mm square. So in this case, we need to determine the first condition is nodal displacement. So this means that we need to find out the value of Q1 and Q2. Second condition is we need to find out the stress in the element. We need to find out the value of sigma in the third problem. Let us see this figure. The figure, it is looking like a cantilever beam. The cantilever beam is nothing but the one end of the beam is rigidly fixed, and the another end of the beam on which the x displacement is acting. Okay, and the total length of this cantilever beam, it is given as 1200 mm. On the cantilever beam, the UDL load is acting. So here the UDL load value, it is not given. If it is not given, then we need to assume as 100 newton per meter. 100 newton per meter. Okay dear, first of all we have to write down the given data. In the given data, you have to represent the uniformly distributed load. It is represented by PO equal to, we need to assume the value 100 newton per meter. Okay dear, if it is not given, then we need to assume. If it is given, then whatever the value is given in the question, we need to follow the same thing. Is it right? Done. The UDL load, if you want to convert in mm, 100 as it is, okay, so we know very well 1 meter equal to how much here? 1000 mm. If it is move above, mean should be how much? It should be 10 power of plus 3. 100 into 10 power of 3 newton per millimeter. Then Young's modulus, how much is given here? 70 gigapascal is given. So if you want to convert in millimeter, 70 as it is, giga value is 10 power of 9. 1 pascal is equal to 1 newton per meter square. How much? 1 pascal is equal to 1 newton per meter square. Then if you want to convert in millimeter square, 1 meter square. Okay, 1 meter square equal to 10 power of 6 mm square. This 10 power of 6 and 10 power of 9, the remaining should be how much dear? The remaining should be 10 power of 3 only. Okay dear, I hope so no one is having the doubt, because already we solved a lot of practice in the strength of material. Okay dear, third one, the cross sectional area, how much is given here? The cross sectional area of this material is given as A equal to 10 power of 4 mm square. Step number 1. The finite element model for a given continuum. So let us think about it. This is the first node. and this is the second node. First node, second node. Of the total length of this cantilever beam, how much? 1200 mm. So it is represented by LE equal to 1200 mm. So in this case, what we need to find out? We need to find out the displacement. So the nodal displacement, then it is represented by Q. The nodal displacement is acting at a point of 1. Here is 2. The nodal displacement is acting at a point of 2. So how's it? The load is uniformly. How's it? The here in this case, the load is remain constant from the first end to the second end. Okay, dear. Then where Q1 and Q2 represent nodal displacement. In the step number 2, we need to determination of elemental stiffness matrix. Is it right? So if you want to represent the elemental stiffness matrix, it is represented by KE. E is indicate that elemental. K is represent the stiffness matrix. Elemental stiffness matrix equal to AE EE by LE 1 minus of 1 minus 1 1 equal to. So here the area value is given. How much is area given? 10 power of 4 into the modulus of elasticity, or we can say as Young's modulus values. How much is given here? 70 into 10 power of 3 it is given, divided by. So total length of this cantilever beam, how much is given? 1200 mm. 1 minus 1 minus 1 into 1. So if you divide this whole the value, then you will get 5.833 into 10 power of 5. I'm taking here direct. Is it right? 10 power of 5 as it is. If you multiply 5.833 into 1, it should be how much? 5.833. 5.833 into minus 1 should be minus 5.833. If you multiply again, 5.1 into 5.833 should be how much? Minus 5.833. Here also 5.833. Okay. Step number 3. In the step number 3, we need to determination of global stiffness matrix. We need to find out the value of K. The K is indicate global stiffness matrix. So this global stiffness matrix always equal to elemental stiffness matrix. Global stiffness matrix always equal to elemental stiffness matrix. K equal to, this value should be same. K equal to 10 power of 5.833 minus 5.833 minus 5.833 as it is. Okay, after that, in the step number 4, we need to determination of global vector as well as displacement vector we need to find out. This displacement vector, it is represented by Q equal to, here how many nodes are there? 2 nodes. Let us see here. This is the first node and second node, Q1, Q2. We can represent here Q1, Q2. And the force vector is represent, because we have how many displacement vector? We have 2 displacement vector, Q1 and Q2, and force vector also should be how many? 2 only. But this is the form of which one? UDL load. If it is UDL load, it will be there, then we have to use this formula, PO into L by 2 F1 F2 F1 F2, or we can say as W into L by 2, 1 or 1, you can say. Okay, dear. Then here PO is indicate that UDL load is acting. Which load is acting here? The UDL load is acting whom? On the cantilever beam. UDL load, how much we assume? 100 into 10 power of 3. The total length of this cantilever beam, how much is that here? 1200 mm by 2, 1, 1 as it is. If you divide this whole this value, then you will get the answer is 60 into 10 power of 6, 1, 1. So After that, just you need to multiply this term 60 into 10 power of 6 into 1 should be how much? 60 into 10 power of 6. Here also 60 into 10 power of 6. So from that one we got the value of force vector value. After the getting the displacement vector value and force vector value, after that we need to find out the equilibrium equation for a continuum. We need to find out. So the k's indicate that global stiffness matrix. Q is represent the displacement vector equal to nodal force vector. So k value is how much is given here? K we know very well. 10 power of 5, 5.833 minus 5.833 minus 5.833, 5.833. Just you have to represent here. And Q values how much is that here? Q1, Q2 equal to F value how much? 60 into 10 power of 6, 60 into 10 power of 6. So we know very well the cantilever beam in which the one end is fixed and another end is free. If the node 1 is fixed. So let us see this figure. So this one is fixed. How is it right? This is node 1, this is node 1 and this is node 2. Node 1, if it is fixed, then Q1 value should be how much? 0. Q1 value should be how much? It should be 0. Okay. Let us see. Then Q1 value should be how much? It should be 0. So for that reason, we need to eliminate first row, first column, first row and first column. Is it right? Then after that, we need to apply the boundary condition. So this is a elimination approach method. Which method here? Elimination approach method. 10 power of 5 as it is. Remaining should be how much only? 5.833 multiply by which one? Q2. 5.833 multiply by Q2 equal to remaining is 60 into 10 power of 6. So after that you need to divide this whole the value here toward this side. So 60 into 10 power of 6 divided by 10 power of 5 into 5.83. if you divide, then you will get with the help of calci is 102.915 mm. Okay dear, so we understood that Q1 value is 0 because of it is a fixed end. Q1 value is 0 because of fixed end. Q2 value is 102.915 mm. Okay dear. Step number 7. In the step number 7, in which we got the value of Q1, Q2, one condition is completed. Again, the second condition, what we need to find out? We need to determine the stresses as well as if we need to determine the strain. Is it right? The first of all, we need to solve the strain. So what is the formula? Strain, it is represented by E equal to B. It's a matrix, B matrix into nodal displacement. So B value how much is given here? B know very well, 1 by LE minus 1, 1, Q1. This Q value nothing but Q1, Q2. 1 by total length of the cantilever beam, it is given as 1200 mm, minus 1, 1, Q1 value, because the Q1 is fixed. Q1 is pretty fixed, mean should be 0. 0. Q2 value how much we got here? 102.915. After that, 1 by 1200 as it is, we need to multiply rho into this column. Rho into this column. Minus 1 into 0 plus 1 into 102.915. So after that, 1 by 1200 as it is. Okay. So minus 1 into 0 should be 0 plus 1 into 102.915 should be how much? 102.915 only. If you divide 102.915 by 1200, then you will get the value of strain is how much? 0.08576. Because the strain is not having any unit, it is a dimensionless unit. Okay, dear. After that, we need to find out the value of stress. If you want to find out the value of stress, which formula we have to use? E into B into Q. This B into Q, what we can say here? This B into Q we can say as strain. B into Q nothing but strain. E nothing but, capital E nothing but modulus of elasticity, or we can say as Young's modulus. The Young's modulus value already given in the question. How much is given? 70 into 10 power of 3 Newton per mm square. It is given. Into strain is how much? 0.08576. If you just multiply this term, then you will get the value of stress is 6003.2 Newton per mm square. The unit of stress is Newton per mm square. I hope so. No one is having the doubt up to here. After the getting of stress and strain, then what we need to find out? We need to find out the reaction at the support. We need to find out, that is a must and should. Okay, then you will get the full marks. If you want the full marks, then you need to follow this method. Okay dear, then R equal to R nothing but the reaction, how much reaction is acting at node 1 as well as at node 2, we need to find out. R equal to K. K nothing but global stiffness matrix. Q nothing but nodal displacement minus F. Nothing but nodal, this F is nothing but nodal force vector. What we can say here? Nodal force vector. How to remember? R equal to KQ minus of F. R equal to KQ minus of F. That's it. Then R, how many nodes we have here? We have two nodes. Then how many normal reactions will be acting? Two normal reaction is acting. First is R1, another one is R2. That's it. R1, R2 equal to K value already we saw. How much? 10 power of 5, 5.833 minus 5.833 minus 5.833, 5.833. That's it. Q value, how many displacement we have? Q1, Q2. Q1, Q2 minus how many rotor force we have? 2, F1, F2, that's it. R1, R2 equal to 10 power of 5. Here, this value should be remaining same. The Q1 value should be how much here? 0. Q2 value already we saw. How much? 102.915 minus F1 value already we have solved. How much? 16 into 10 power of 6. F2 also 16 into 10 power of 6. After that, R1, R2 as it is. 5 point, I'm keeping up to here as it is only. R1 by R2 equal to 10 power of 5. So in this case, what we have to do? Always remember this row into this column. We need to multiply this row, this above, first above row into this column, below this row into this column. Okay, dear. Then 5 I'm doing here. 5.833 multiplied by 0 minus 5.833 into 102.915. Here, just in the bottom side, minus 5.833 multiplied by 0 plus 5.833 multiplied by 102.915. Minus 60 into 10 power of 6, 60 into 10 power of 6. So after that, if you want to solve R1 value, then take above this value, R1 equal to 10 power of 5. This above value we have to consider. 5.833 into 0 minus 5.833 into 102.915 minus 60 into 10 power of 6. So if you calculate this whole the value, then you will get the answer is minus 60 into 10 power of 6. Here also minus 60 into 10 power of 6. So because minus into minus, it should be how much? Minus only, because this is minus minus, we need to add here. Okay, so it should be how much? 60 plus 60 and 60 should be 120 into 10 power of 6. The value of normal reaction, what will be the unit? The unit of normal reaction is Newton. What is the unit is that here? Newton. How much we got? R1 value is minus 120 in 2 10 power of 6 Newton. Again, what we need to find out? We need to find out the normal reaction is acting at a point of 2. We need to find out. R2 equal to 10 power of 5. Just we need to take this bottom value. 5.833 into 0 plus 5.833 into 102.915 minus 60 into 10 power of 6. So after that, if you multiply this whole the value, then you will get the answer is 60 into 10 power of 6. Again, minus 60 into 10 power of 6. If it is a positive, negative, if it is the sign will be there, then you need to cancel these terms. Then you will get the answer is 0 Newton. The unit of, so the normal reaction value, how much is there? 0 Newton. We got it. Okay, dear. After the getting of the value of R1 and R2, then we have to represent the result. This result is most important for the external examiner. Is it right? So the nodal displacement value, how much is that here? Q1, because it is a fixed end, the value should be, Q1 value should be 0. And Q2 is 102.915 mm. And the induced, how much maximum stress is induced in the cantilever beam is how much is there? 6003.2 Newton per mm square. That much maximum stress is induced in the cantilever beam. Okay, and the third one, the reaction at the support. So how much normal reaction is acting at the node 1 is how much is that? Minus 120 into 10 power of 6 Newton load is acting on the cantilever beam. What about the R2? How much normal reaction is acting at a node of 2? We need to find it. R2 value should be how much? 0 Newton will be there. Okay dear. I hope so. No one is having the doubt regarding this class. And guys, please like, okay, and comment and subscribe my channel, because I'm putting the more effort to solving by easiest method. So I will solve the entire problem. Okay, you can solve any type of the problem, okay, within fraction of second. So please follow my method. My method is unique and simplest method you can easily understand, as well as you can easily grasp. Okay dear, thank you.